The transition to digital selling to me is like, wait, what have y'all been doing? Like, this is what we do. Right. But where we noticed, like with the team, it was about month 2.5 to 3 where the mindset was different because we didn't have that social connection anymore internally, right? Like when you're sitting on the floor, right, and you can hear people selling, you can hear deals closing, right? That brings energy. When things go wrong, you have that immediate support system to bring you up because people know something went wrong. About 2.5, 3 months in is when people really started to be way more up here and a little bit more of that burnout starts setting in, a little bit more of this negativity is the wrong word, but it's like feeling beat up, right? Yeah. Because you didn't have that immediate like social, right? Like if you and I are on the floor and you had this big deal you were expecting to come in and I hear you get off the call where you just heard them say like, yeah, we're gonna push next quarter. And you're like, next quarter? Okay, da-da-da, and you hang up. I'm right there to be like, oh, man, like,
exactly.
was that, you know, so that's where the main challenges are to come in is like, how do you support people through the ups and downs when they're by themselves, right? So we've tried to do a lot of things there, but that was the first big challenge that we ran into. Systems, processes, messaging, all that, like, we were already system-based. We were fine. This was the hard part of keeping people engaged.
The word that I use to describe that is serendipity. It's how do you manufacture random, you know, like, oh man, oh, did you hear that? How do you manufacture that? So as you're taking through the journey, anything that you found successful in the inner workings of where teams have done a good job of continuing, you know, at least a piece of that serendipity that happens when you're in person.
So it's so funny, man. Like you actually, this is going to sound counterintuitive, but to my leaders, you have to schedule it.
Yeah.
You have to schedule it. It needs to be on your calendar, Jake, on my calendar. Any of the leaders is on your calendar. Reach out to someone you haven't spoken to recently. Because that, like, you know, people that have worked with me or for me know this. Like, I'm not a social butterfly. Like, I'm not Mr. like extrovert. That's not who I am. But in the office, like, obviously, if I see you, I'm chatting with you, all those things happen. When we went remote, it was like, it was right around that 3 month mark. I was like, there's people I haven't spoken to in months, right? Especially when your org is 100+ people, right? Like just not even speaking to. So the first is putting it on your calendar. When am I going to, I'm reaching out to someone I haven't spoken to recently. And this doesn't have to be a heavy Zoom call of like, hey, let's, but I was like, hey, been a minute. How's it going? And like those check-ins, that's the first. Second is, and I worked on this with my managers in a big way, like spiffs and recognition need to be significantly less transactional, meaning you need to give first more. More often than not, especially with sales teams, like all spiffs are like, if you do this, then I'll do that. That's a transaction. That's not a relationship, right? If someone has to give for you to give love, that's a transaction.
Interesting.
So where I was working with my managers, like this month, you have to do something unconditional. Unconditional. Do something for your team that has nothing tied to a result. Just do it, right? And helping managers think that way of like reward them, recognize them for things, right? Also, another, I'm gonna go super tactical here. So that was one. Next one is, again, to the Jakes, to the Me's, to the managers of the world, add to your one-on-one docs people that need to be shout it out, right? So who on your team needs a pick-me-up and who on your team is doing well? And then this is something that I have, generally speaking, I have a no slack rule during meetings and one-on-ones, except for this part of the one-on-one. Because in the one-on-one, I'm like, yo, Rebecca, Jake just said some really cool shit about you. He says like, you've really been working hard this month, like keep it up. So it's in the moment, like that, it's those types of things that go a long way that I've seen be more serendipitous than like, yes, that we all did the Zoom happy hours. That was cool for a week and then they sucked, right? Like we've done like the lunch and learns, we've done the virtual coffee meetups, like all those things are there. But for the leaders where you can plan serendipity, right? Go into next week, I challenge all y'all. Have coffee with two people next week that you haven't, or tea if you're Jake, right? Especially with tea, hit them up right now and be like, yo, let's catch up Friday. Want to grab some coffee? Like virtually, cool. You have to plan it so that it can be serendipitous to the other side. It doesn't have to be serendipitous to you. It needs to be serendipitous to them.
That's right, because they don't know what's coming, right? You're just hitting up out of the blue, and to them it feels like that. And how did your managers early on, I mean, how did they respond to that, right? So you've got these people they've been used to, you know, just seeing the team. Like, how did they respond to it? And, like, were there any, like, roadblocks you all had early on in getting it more institutionalized?
Of course, right? Like, because you also – going fully remote exposed the people that didn't have processes in place, right? If you have to – first of all, if you have to be there to get the behavior that you expect, it means you don't have the culture that you need to have. If I have to be on that floor to get the behavior that I expect, something's massively wrong culturally. Second, if you don't have processes in place and then you go remote, yeah, like, shit falls apart because you don't know how things were being done. So, again, like, quite literally – It is a highlight. I don't even know if I can call this a highlight of my career, but it's one of the most proud moments I've ever had for my team. Was April of 2020, right? So we're talking like peak.
Right, this is like right into it.
Okay, April. We did a unfortunate, just a massive riff, right? Like, we sell to doctors in a, and we went fully remote, and my team. I mean, my God, did they rise to the occasion in that month. I mean, y'all, I don't know if you can see this, like, literal goosebumps talking about this. Like, they,
I love it.
Nothing changed. Like, they got after it and they ran their process and they did what they were supposed to do. And, like, we didn't hit the number in April, but my God, what am I proud of how they got after it, right? So, like, behaviorally, process-wise, it was fine. This was the hard part, and that's where with managers, that's where they struggled the most, is because you couldn't see it anymore, right? Like, if we're on the floor and you walk in and you look like shit, I know something's up and I can pull you aside. Like, yo, Jake, like, what's up, man, right? Or I can hear, like, the subtle things, right? Someone gets off a tough call. I can pull you aside, right? Mm-hmm. And be like, hey, like, that it was the lack of being aware of, like, how people were really feeling that the managers really struggled with. Where are they spending their time? Where are things going wrong? And learning how to observe remotely, right? Which, again, isn't as hard as we make it sound. How do you observe someone remotely?
You turn on
the camera and you schedule, like, hey, I'd love to, like, listen in on a call, or, hey, like, I'd love to, could you show me how you're scrubbing those leads again? Like, you mentioned in your one-on-one, right? So, like, again, planning the observation was big, right? The biggest one that I'm now trying to figure out is, you know, especially for new reps. So this has been, I would say, my biggest challenge is ramps taking longer. And you know me, Jake, like, I'm Mr. Coach and Mr. Onboard. Like, I built these programs out and we have a very strong program, but one is went full remote, ramp is taking longer.
Makes sense, yeah.
People aren't retaining information as well. And I think part of that is just when you're not around it 24/7, it's different. When you were a new rep, and I had a no hiding rule, right? Again, if anyone's on here that's worked for me or with me, you know this. I had a no hiding rule. You were a new rep, you could not hide to make your calls. And new reps,
you
know,
you
do this,
right?
Yes, you go to the
same shit.
yeah, you go to the conference room, you go make calls. I have people make calls from there. Car, right? Like, that's, you hide. Hard. We had a no hiding rule. You had to be on the floor because I wanted people to hear you so they could give you that feedback and that encouragement. So I'm trying to figure out better ways to allow that to happen. How could, like, literally, like, I've written down, like, how could I, like, live stream everyone's calls at once and put it on Sonos? You follow me here? Like, this is the bad shit, Craig. Just in the background, right? Or, like, hey, Gong, if you're listening, or Outreach that you're listening, disposition gets set to meeting set, bow, blast the call link out to everybody immediately. Here was a win. Listen, right? Like, write that down. It's like, how do you get people hearing the wins? Because you know this, man, if you're in your own world and you're not winning that day and you're not hearing wins, you think no one's winning.
Yeah.
So we've been doing way more sharing of, like, wins. But then, again, this is the other part of it, the storytelling, right? Like, my managers know this, like, in our SDR channel and our AE channel, like, you know, a deal closes, like, ding, or, like, we booked a meeting, ding. I'm like, goddamn dings. Like, it's just distracting all day.
Right.
I don't want the ding. I want the story, because that's what's missing. right? Ding, ding, ding. You're seeing all these meetings being hit. In the office, you knew the story because you heard
it. Exactly.
Remotely, you don't. So share the story. Who are you talking to? What objection did you get? How did you turn it around? Why did they say yes to the meeting and why are you excited about it? Sharing that, now people feel like that's part of their win too. So getting way more better at one, speaking English, and two, telling stories throughout the day remotely is also a much better way to bring people together.